Game On is brought to you by
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1x Bet.
Game On. It's Game On. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
Yes, indeed. Welcome back from that break. Well, we could actually call it the second half of the show. In case you're just joining us, you're still watching Game On, and it's Friday, so we started looking ahead for a very exciting weekend when it comes to the world of sports. But speaking of sports, the Uganda Cranes, as we speak right now, are currently down in Djibouti ahead of the massive clash tomorrow, where they'll be up against Somalia. This is a CHAN 2020 qualifier, and this is also the first leg of the first preliminary round. So it's going to be a very exciting tournament for the boys. Now, interestingly, there's a new interim head coach that is in charge of the team. That is Abdallah Mubiru, who comes in to replace the man, Sebastian Disabre, who did depart a couple of weeks ago to join Pyramids down in Egypt. Now, Hope, quickly kick us off, because it's a very interesting squad that was summoned. A couple of big names dropped by the head coach. And what should we be expecting from Abdallah Mubiru, and specifically the game tomorrow against Somalia, the first leg?
Well, first of all, like I said last time out, football is very funny and it's so unpredictable. You don't know what you'll find out. The fact that, Somalia is ranked lower than Uganda Cranes, so I think we have the cutting edge. And for me, looking at the game and the squad itself, I was seeing all the noise on social media how some of the big stars were dropped. But the truth is, if you look at the players, actually, I think the final third, you look at Nelson Senkatuka, who was dropped. And then they chose Patrick Kadu. For goodness sake, I think he's a better player, because if you look at the pecking order, Patrick Kadu will always be the better player, because he, playing in the African Cup of Nations, he has the experience, he has the exposure, he knows what it takes to play for the Uganda Cranes. And looking at that squad itself, I think it's a very good squad, balanced from the back line, the midfield, and going forward. But we all know that our problem has been scoring goals, and I think, I don't know what they're going to do. Coach Mobidu talked about it actually when they're heading out going to Somalia. He talked about how they've struggled a lot, actually, in the friendlies, you can imagine. You know, such against teams down in Chitara,
they couldn't score
goals. So I think there's a lot to be worked on, but those are some of the small mistakes that the Coach Mobidu has to rectify before the tougher games. Because if you look at Somalia, like I said, it's not a big big team, but I think we can have, we can go out and get the job done.
Nick, looking at the squad that was summoned, it's predominantly players from two sides. KCCA, which has got 9 players, or they've got Vipers, who've got 4 players on, the team. What should we be making of the squad that has been called on? But then also, some people think Somalia is probably a little bit of an underdog. We're playing at a neutral ground down in Djibouti. Does that play into our favour?
I tell you what, the Uganda Cranes, I need to take Somalia quite seriously, because if you want to front that beat of Somalia not being the side that plays good football, then we might be surprised. We might be in for a very, very long night down in Djibouti tomorrow. But going back to the team selection, of course, she mentions Nelson Senkatuka, a man who knows the story around the UPL, because he's been banging in the goals for Bright Stars last season. But he can't seem to find the final say when it comes to the national team selection. We saw him struggle in CHAN 2018 down in Morocco. He didn't get the first team selection like he thought he would get. And then, of course, you've got to bring in Patrick Kadu. He's an area threat. He knows his way around the penalty area, and also the way he handled himself. The experience, yes. But for Abdallah Mubiru, he knows that a win, or should I say a qualification to that is CHAN 2022, rather 2020, will actually have him, or just might have him, secure this job on a permanent deal. But for the Uganda Cranes, I want to believe that Somalia will not be taken for granted, or should not be taken for granted, because of that footballing reasons. Going forward, knowing that Uganda Cranes have never qualified from the group stages, right from the first edition 2011, going into the second 2014, South Africa, Rwanda, Morocco, during the stint of Disabre, that formula will play in mind. Yes, you qualify, but when you qualify, you don't compete, but rather make numbers. So for Coach Abdallah Mubiru, I think the bigger test will be going past Somalia, and then meeting either Burundi or South Sudan, and then doing well in the group stages coming through in next year.
If I remember right, last year when Sebastian Disabre was introduced onto the national team, that was pretty much just around the time when we were going into the CHAN 2018. And the team looked like they were struggling. Obviously, so much has happened ever since he's now departed. Some probably think he's left quite the footprint on the team. And these 4 players that were part of the AFCON team, does this contribute in terms of the performance for the side?
I think so. It's always good to have some old brooms in there, just who know their corner around the football team or the locker room. And when you look on that squad, obviously the presence of Awanyi in there, the presence of that is a wanted Alan Chambade, Patrick Kadu as well, it kind of adds a lot. on that squad, Tadeu Oluwanga as well. This is a squad that probably, for me, can, you know, score 5 or 6 against Somalia. But again, you've got to aware in, you've got to bring in that bit of Somalia being the other side, whereby no one is giving them a chance. So with the Uganda Cranes, they might be favorites on paper. They might have the right players to actually go there and win them the game against that is Somalia. But bearing in mind that we haven't really done so well in terms of qualifying from the group stages, and also the fact that we have so many players, that for me was a statement. Him dropping Nelly and Iwan Paul Mucharazi was an indication. It was an indication that he's got spoil for choice. And even then, if he gets this wrong, I mean, sometimes you've got the right kind of players who click the right way, but you can't have them play together. And that for me will be a worrying factor. But moving forward, the preparations, the goalless draw against Pro Line, and that defeat against the, I think, in Hoima.
You want
to think, I'm not really going to focus on that result, but rather on the performance. How well did the team play against those respective sides? But moving forward, tomorrow should be a win in the bag, and hopefully get the job done the second leg next week in Lugogo.
Right, that is the Uganda Cranes team for you. It's Dwight Defe. I want to wish them the best of luck going into the big game tomorrow. It will be played down in Djibouti. It's also the first leg of their Chan 2020 qualifiers. So we're certainly hoping that the boys can go out there and get the job done before they host, Somalia right here in Kampala at the Startime Stadium in Lukoko for the return leg. But quickly, I want us to move on now away from the Uganda Cranes, though. There's some massive news coming through from FUFA. They've confirmed that they'll actually be taking care of all the air transport, expenses regarding the two sides that will be representing us on the continent. That is KCCA and Proline. Do remember, KCCA will be representing Uganda in the CAF Champions League, and then Proline will actually be playing in the CAF Confederations Cup. But both sides will have to kick off with the preliminary qualifiers. Now, I hope that is such a massive boost for both of these clubs, because you're thinking, first of all, it takes away that burden in terms of, the travel expenses. And FUFA have come out and say that they'll offer 25 tickets. 17 of these will belong to the players. 8 of those will actually be for the officials. Is this a step in the right direction, especially for Ugandan football?
I think it is, because if you look at what happened during the African Cup of Nations, we do not want to see the same thing happening. So I think it's a good thing for the boys. And another thing is that the FIFA itself has already struggled. For me, I won't believe anything until I said it has been done. The money has been given. The boys have been, well catered for. The welfare is there. The transport is there. Everything is there, for the boys to travel and, play their games. So I think before it's done, I won't believe anything, because sometimes, you need evidence to come out and say that, FIFA has said this and this is going to be done. So apart from that, I'm not going to say anything about that.
Nick, quickly, before you get to come in, I remember when, Proline won the Uganda Cup, there was a bit of reservation on whether or not they would be able to go out there and get to play in the CAF Confederations Cup. But FUFA have come out through a statement and confirmed that they're willing to give a helping hand. We all know KC has been there in the past, which means that, for a team like Proline, they're following up.
The million-dollar question would be, where have they been to actually, come through such initiatives? Mm. But it was a very good, suggestion or gesture to actually try and, meet the expense of these sides, especially away from home, because we know for a fact that CAF only comes in when you've qualified for the continent events in regards to your travel expenditure. But for FUFA to actually come out and say this, for me, it was good news, especially for Proline and KCFs, who will be enjoying this fast benefit, knowing that these CAF games away from home come quite in handy in terms of expenditure. But moving forward, we've seen over the last couple of, 3 years, we saw AC Villa, Vipers saying no to the games when Pider couldn't afford the outreach in terms of the away games, and this was all because they didn't have the amount of money to see them partake in the CAF game. So I want to believe that if FUFA come out to run to the rescue, then it's a good plus. But the question will be, can they sustain gesture going forward?
That's the big question. Is there structure in terms of...
That is something we do not know at the moment. What we know is they are willing, or in quotes, they are wanting to help out financially games that are, away from home. But for me, that is something we'll have to hear from Ahmed Hussein and company in regards to whether they'll actually have continuity in this particular gesture. But moving forward, it's a plus, and it's a good thing for Proline, because I say Proline because for KCFC, I would imagine they have a very large budget for these financial games, because they know for a fact that during the course of the year, the objective is to qualify for CAF games and also to win maybe the league or or something of the sort. So for Proline, yes, they got some good monies from the Uganda Cup and also the big league, but the worrying factor is how they're going to meet the travel expenses away from home, especially the game against Malawi. Yeah. The Malawian side, that's Master Services FC, Master Security Services FC. That is, what, 3,000 miles away from here? So it's a good thing from FUFA. Okay.
That is Proline for you. They'll be playing in the CAF Confederations Cup preliminary round against the team from Malawi. That is Master Fire Services Football Club. Also, KCCA in the first round will be playing against a team from Namibia, that is African Stars. We're expecting a very interesting round of games for the fans. But hey, I want to wish the two clubs the best of luck going into those two competitions. Let's quickly switch gears now and talk a bit of rugby, because there is a new tournament coming through for the fans. And this one here is the Victoria Cup for the Uganda Rugby Cranes, coached by the main man Robert Seguia. They'll be in action tomorrow. That is against the Sabres from Zimbabwe. Promises to be a very exciting tournament either. Quickly, Hope, Zimbabwe, what should you be expecting from this game?
For me, I think it's going to be a very tough opposition for the Uganda Cranes. And I think for me, the Rugby Cranes, what they're looking at this moment is that they have to bounce back from the defeat against, you know, Kenya. And for me, the good thing is that some of the players were dropped. There's a bit of rotation in the squad, and it should be a good thing, because we saw against Kenya down at Chadondo, leaving some of the players who are struggling, not putting up, you know, good performances, and then he left them on the pitch. Yet he had, you know, good players on the bench who are game changers. So I think in terms of going forward, he has seen that some of the changes are needed in the squad. But then also, we have enough armor really to, you know, to beat Zimbabwe. The last time out, in the last outing, the first outing we lost to them, and then the last season actually in the Elgon Cup we beat them 39-10. So I think they should be looking at that, and should give them the confidence. And then I think the fact that Zimbabwe has been training and playing in, you know, in South Africa, that's different. That's a different environment. And coming to Uganda here, knowing Uganda Cranes has been, you know, sorry, the Rugby Cranes have been playing within Uganda, it's a different story. So I think we have all our good boys in the squad. We have the likes of Phil Paul Crutch, who has been there celebrating 10 years, you know, playing for the Rugby Cranes. You have some good players in there. You have Zaira, who's a notable player for, you know, Pirates. You have so many other good players, you know, in the rugby team that can really get the job done. And for Robert Seguia, he knows that this is, you know, a tough test for him, and he has to get that job done before he takes on Zimbabwe.
Okay, let's jump into a very short break. When we come back after the break, I'll definitely be talking to Nick about the Rugby Cranes. There's a big story coming through from boxing, though quite the sad one. There's Formula One coming through this weekend, and then Saturday we'll be talking some of the pre-season action from the biggest clubs across Europe. So all that plus so much more is coming through after the break. Stay with us.
Game on. It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
Game on is brought to you by
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.